Now that will change your coffee shop conversations, your everyday meetings suddenly becomes the Holy of Holies. Because God's there. Isn't that what Jesus said? Where two of you, two or three are gathered, I'm there. He's ready to meet with us in such a personal and intimate way. So what I wanted to get across today is that there's a knowledge which is birthed from intimacy. And the whole purpose of our communication is not just to stir one another intellectually, although that happens as a consequence, but the whole purpose is to create the atmosphere in which people can encounter God Himself, in which you link people not to yourself or to one another, but you link them to the source, to the eye of the fountain, to Christ in you. So that even when you depart, like Paul said, you know, not just in my presence, but much more in my absence, will this truth ignite and produce a lifestyle. So that when you leave, people are just as much aware of the indwelling Christ as when you were with them. I remembered again the story of the disciples on the road to Emmaus who saw all the events of Christ unfold in front of their eyes, yet they were sad. You see, our accurate knowledge, no one today has got the more accurate knowledge of what happened on the cross historically as those two guys who witnessed it themselves. Yet their historic knowledge of Christ left them sad, left their lives unchanged. There's a deeper understanding of Christ, a deeper revelation of a Christ that's more than the Christ of history, but the Christ who came to unveil your true life, your true identity. And when we encounter Him, we suddenly see that, like those disciples in the breaking of the bread, He disappears because they discovered that God's preferred location is man. That he has made up His mind that He doesn't want to exist in any other form but in man. He's with you. He's for you. And our communication, when we start understanding that, our communication with one another takes on a new dimension. Because we're aiming not for your head, but for your heart. For a spirit dimension that will overwhelm your mind. It will take you into places of understanding that is impossible to reach through just the study of the scriptures. Because it's the spirit that gives life to the written word. It's the spirit that awakens the truth, and the truth of what's written here is a reality that lives within you. Now in 1 Corinthians 2, let me go there, just to show you again how God wants to take us even beyond our memory of wonderful testimonies of things He's done in the past. Yes, that's good. But He always wants to keep us in the freshness of a present awareness of His indwelling. Yeah, in 1 Corinthians 3 from verse 19, says, "For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God. For it's written, He catches the wise in their own craftiness. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, but they are futile." See, if you try and understand Him through your own logic and the way in which you, through your own talented intellectual capability, can work Him out, God just laughs. "Therefore, let no one boast in men, for all things are yours. Whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas or the world or life or death or things present or things to come, all is yours. I read that one day and suddenly realized that there is nothing in my future that can add anything to me, because it's all mine already. The only thing the future holds is a further manifestation, a further unveiling of the reality of what is mine already in Christ. Jesus had a habit of saying, the time is coming and now is. He had a habit of pulling even the future into the present. Of saying, the kingdom of God is at hand. It has come. He didn't live in just a nostalgic memory of how God dealt with Israel in the past. Neither did he bring just a sense of you need to hope for what is to come. But he brought people into an immediate encounter with the living God. The time is coming and now is. When he spoke to the woman at the well in John 4, he says, you don't have to wait any longer or search any further. I am he. And I just want to say to you today that he is present wherever you are right now. He is there to encounter with you. Don't wait a moment longer. Don't search a moment further. Just say, Lord, here I am. Overwhelm me. Thank you, Father, for doing that right now. Thank you, Jesus, for overwhelming people with such an awareness of who you are and who they are in you. In Jesus' name.